While Ship of Theseus was rolling out, we got our hands on this 650-page stunning storyboard that Rahi made. We had known Rahi for a while then. It was enough to, you know, get us all excited to make this film.
I remember the first time when Rahi spoke about this idea. Originally, it was supposed to be three different stories. Only three known incidents in Tumbbad. There was supposed to be a Sutradhar at bus station of Tumbbad where, you know, he would narrate it to the audience. What Anand and Mitesh did after that was they made it one person's story, which is Vinayak.
It kept evolving, it kept changing. Between 50 to 70 drafts in past 18 years. Tumbbad is a story of Vinayak's family. Vinayak's first generation, second generation, third generation.
Men are more sinister than the demons that they face. That one golden coin, it goes to like a few golden coins, which goes to like looting the bank.
We've decided that we'll divide the story in three parts then, but we need to know why are we doing it and what is the logic, what is the reason for it.
The time periods are divided into feudal, imperial, capitalistic, the Sarkar, the feudal lord, or when Vinayak becomes a Sarkar, or when Bharat Sarkar comes in.
The shifting of old India into this modern India, everything, somehow these dots, I just found them very attractive to connect together.
Tumbbad mein kya hai?
Agar koi aisa devta ho jo tujhe chhue, aur tu amar ho jaye, 500-700 saal jiye, to tu aisa chahega?
After being touched by Hastar, all the three characters who have been touched in the film, they all look for Mukti. They don't want this never-ending cycle of life. The one person who's really lived it the longest was the grandmother.
My favorite character is grandmother because, you know, she gave this opportunity to me to just go completely crazy with her. In my own way, that's my homage to, you know, all the 80s Hindi horror films that I've seen of, you know, this Bhutia Haveli, Wahan Pe Khazana Hai.
We also had a backstory which never made it to the film. She's an ancestor to the feudal lord. She is like 400 years old or something. And we wanted to show a really young woman who had just come into this house, you know, gotten married and learning the tricks of this treasure hunting trade, which is extremely dangerous, in which she did it with ease. And probably one mistake somewhere which brought it all down for her.
Purti ki Devi, antahin sone aur anaj ka prateek hai.
When you start, you don't have all the answers. You know roughly that, you know, how the film is going to end.
Like the myth of Hastar, it came in after the entire film was made.
It was the last edition in the film in terms of writing. It needed to serve the purpose of also introduction to the world, to give a backstory of an important element in the film.
Par ek din hamare hi purvajon ne use yaad kiya aur uske naam ka mandir bana diya.
We had set rules, you know, while writing.
That everything should be very logical. Nothing would be metaphysical in that sense. Even the creatures in the film, they don't have superpowers like, you know, they can read your mind. They can't. They can't do some magic by lifting themselves up.
A lot of people have asked me if it was really challenging writing Hastar. Rather, Hastar was the easiest to write because he never went against his nature. There is not a single expectation that Hastar subverts, you know, throughout the film. He goes as he's expected to. He does exactly what we know he's going to do.
The other part of it was making sure to not have, you know, jump scares.
Because startling is not scaring. The stories that we hear from grandmothers, the folks, the things that we hear, they keep us awake at night. Startling does not.
Dar raha hai? Abhi toh shuru bhi nahi hua hai.
How do we close this cycle that we've started? That moment happens when his son decides that I don't want to be my father. And for us, that was the closure.
We shot some portions of where he carries along that cycle, but it was a creative call that we all took later. I wish we wouldn't have done that. He overpowered greed, which he shouldn't have been able to. He should have carried it on.
I don't think even when we finished writing, we had all the answers. I think I personally had all the answers when I finished editing the film. Only then I was able to say, okay, this is our final draft of the film.
We kept writing all the time. We wrote before the shoot. We wrote during the shoot. At times we wrote after the shoot. It never ended.
This grandmother scene when Vinayak goes to meet the grandmother, that footage was uneditable in every possible way.
I said, okay, let's just find all the stable shots, which came to like 2 minutes out of this 10-minute scene. We put it all together.
She deleted the audio. She followed the, you know, wide, mid, close. She cut the entire scene and she showed me. She was like, now write the scene. So then that scene was rewritten to suit the visuals. कि जब लिखना था वापस से, I had called Mitesh to the office. I was like कि चल अभी बैठ के इसके डायलॉग करते हैं.
विरासत में मिली हुई हर चीज पर दावा नहीं करना चाहिए.
That's where I had ended my original scene. He was like, "Nay, let's add some more." So he added the grandmother's dialogue, "Ki lalchi hai tu," and he says,
"Ye to gun hai mujhme."
That's how that punchline came in and made the scene even more better.
Because the film got written over a long period of time, we evolved as people. Rahi brings a certain vision to the film, and he brings a lot of visual clarity to his work. Me and Anand have had fun writing this film together. He comes with a lot of clarity of thought, constantly buzzing with ideas. Adesh is the doer of things. He is the one who really works while all of us talk. He's made it what it is today. The way the ambition of this film kept on increasing, all six of us, we got greedy, you know, wanting to make it bigger while making it, while writing it, while shooting it, while editing it, the VFX, everything. I don't know if we found the treasure. I hope we did.